in this life down here below. Sometimes our loved ones are called home. It leaves such an emptiness inside. But what a comfort it is to know they're just asleep at rest with the Lord. Christians never die, they only say goodbye. Goodbye to pain and woe, hello to a brand new home. Goodbye to sin and strife, hello to a brand new life. Goodbye to all the trouble Satan caused us here below. Oh, Christians never die, they only say goodbye. Will ever be there. In that land there'll be no more cares, no more tears to dim our eyes again. All former things have passed away. In this land of perfect day, for Christians never die, they all say goodbye. Goodbye to pain and woe, hello to a brand new home. Goodbye to sin and strife, hello to a brand new life. Goodbye to all the trouble Satan caused. Goodbye to pain and woe, hello to a brand new home. Goodbye to sin and strife, hello to a brand new life. Goodbye to all the trouble Satan caused us here below. Oh, Christians never say goodbye. No, Christians never die, they only say goodbye.
Thank you. soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Shoulders, you raise me up. God for what he's done. Thank you. Family, may his peace.
May his peace be with you till we meet again. May his peace be
till we reach.
Help in trouble. I am the resurrection and the life. He He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. We will commence this morning's Thanksgiving service for the life of Deacon Neville Bernard by singing the hymn, Blessed Assurance.
Creator God, We gather in the midst of death, mourning and weeping. But we come this morning as your people to declare that you are God of living and the dead. From the four corners of this country, and we have come, gracious Lord, gathered to testify about your saving grace and the hope of life we have in you. We come, O God, to give you glory and honor for the life of our brother, friend, uncle, a husband, for the gifts you have bestowed upon him, for the challenges that he experienced and endured. But through them all, O God, you have shaped him and shaped us to be a better people. And so we glorify and magnify your name. We do not understand how the spirit of death moves, when it moves and where it moves and why it moves. But we are confident, O God, that in the midst of death, you are still God and you are still in control. So God of life and death, we invite you to walk with us this morning through this service. As you journey with the psalmist through the valley of the shadow of death, gracious Lord, we pray that you will walk with us as you comfort the weeping and the mourning. Comfort us, O God, through this act of thanksgiving. And in this time, O God, when our faith seems weak and our human limitation is so obvious, we pray, O God, that you will take our hand, as the songwriter says, precious Lord, take my hand. O gracious Lord, we stand, we sit, we bow with our limitations and our weaknesses before us, for we have no control of death. But we come, O God, to declare that our strength is in you, for you are God. So stir us this morning. Stir us this afternoon, O God, to hear testimonies of faith. Help us, O God, to hear testimonies of hope and courage from the life of our brother, and to declare once again that you are God. We pray, O God, that you'll inspire and comfort us this morning into this afternoon. For in and through the words of tributes and song, that our hearts will be comforted. Lord, you're able to touch us this morning. You're able to touch us where words cannot. You're able, O God, to heal wounds where medication cannot. And so, O God, as we invite your presence and as we invite your power and your comforting hand in this experience, we pray, O Lord, that your wounded hand will rest upon us, that you'll hold us close to your bosom, that, O God, at the end we will declare, weeping may endure for a time, but joy comes in the morning. Pour out your power upon us. Pour out your spirit upon us. Pour out your anointing upon us. For indeed, O God, you are God of life. Your God in death, you are the resurrection. In Jesus' name. Amen.
And we rise to acknowledge those among us, the officiating ministers, host pastor, Mr. Barnett, our Assistant Commissioner of Police, Mr. Donovan Graham, in charge of Area 3, Senior Superintendent of Police, Mr. Zita Taylor of Area 3, Superintendent of Police, Ms. Cameron Poyle, Superintendent in Charge, Commanding Officer of the Clarendon Division, our Deputy Superintendent of Police is Ruth Watson, and representing President of the and the President of the District Constable Association, DC Davis, and we want to acknowledge all rank and file members and to say to the family, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord has been good in that he gave him to us. He loved him, he journeyed with us, He blessed us with his talent and his time. He blessed us with his presence. And that itself really being for us from the beginning, from Samuel Coates, a blessing. So we say thanks to the family for giving in to the beginning of Constable Coates. We pray that God will warm your heart as you walk through the valley of death. As we for the reading of the first lesson, our Assistant Commissioner of Police, Mr. Donovan Graham, representing the Commissioner, invited.
Morning, church. First of all, let me, on behalf of the new acting commissioner of police, Ms. Margaret Grant, say condolence to family, friends, colleagues of our dear departed brother. She has sent her tribute, and it is a part of the program, so I invite you to read it. First, let's listen from Psalm 46, verses 1 to 11. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heaven, the heathen raved, the kingdoms were moved, he uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow. He cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. 11th and last. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Here in the reading of the Holy Word.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let me take this opportunity on behalf of the Bethlehem Baptist Church to welcome you to this, the Thanksgiving service of our dear brother, deacon, and friend. Let me ask you to feel free to worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. And for those of you who are standing, we have seats over here and my. It's reserved, okay. All right. For the cell phone, people with their cell phones, please turn them off. We'd be grateful because it will affect the system, and we do not want when the items are being presented, cell phones are being wrong. So please put them on silence or turn them off. At this time, I'm going to invite the Clarendon Police Chorale to come forward with their items, followed by the second lesson, which will be taken from 2 Timothy 4, 1 to 7. And that lesson will be read by the sons of Deacon Bernard, Lorel, and Travis.
God is good.
All the time.
Indeed, God is wonderful. When I'm low in the spirit, I cry, Lord, lift me up.
second lesson will be taken from 2 Timothy chapter 4, from verse 1 to 7. Here beginning. I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at the appearing and the kingdom.
Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine.
For the time I will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears.
And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned in unto fables.
But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof in thy ministry.
For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand.
I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks indeed to the Lord. Deacon Bernard has fought a good fight, and he has a crown laid up in heaven for him. We are down to the tributes, and I must say thanks to the Clarendon Police Chorale for that lovely item. It was quite soothing to the soul, and I am quite sure that the Reeve family will take comfort in those words. The tributes, some of us don't have programs, but we have 6 tributes. And based on my calculation, each tribute will last for 3 minutes. So we have 18 minutes per tribute. So those who are coming up to give their tributes, if you are singing, sing. Don't come up and give a speech and then you sing. If you are coming to give a talk, tribute, in words, verbally, then you do so. Don't come and do both, because we are working with time. Thanks for your cooperation. And the tributes are 6 of them. The first one will be done by the District Constable Association. Then Toriano Bernard, the brother, will come with the second tribute, the third tribute, Mr. Norman Allen, immediate past president of the Jamaica Teachers Association. And we have Bethlehem Sunday School Department will give an item, followed by the Rock River Early Childhood representative, that is Mrs. Dyer. And then yours truly, Mr. Oliver, will bring tribute from the church. So we'll go in that order and announce. So please follow suit. Thank you.
Let the church praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let the church praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Reverend Michael Barnett, host pastor, first chaplain, Reverend Father Tuttle, here at Tree, other members of the clergy, ACP Graham, Senior Superintendent Taylor, Superintendent Powell, DSP Watson, ASP Booth, Choir Director, other senior officers, men, women of the Jamaican Conservative Force, Executive Member of the United District Constable Association, colleague District Constable, members of the family, friend, congregation, morning. On behalf of my family, the Executive Member of the United District Constable Association, and other District Constable, I would like to extend our deepest condolence to the Bernard family, officers of the Division of Clarendon, and other colleagues. Life is a journey. A man of faith. What a friend we have in Jesus. all our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Amidst life, there's death. Life's a journey from birth to death, filled many times with hope, happiness, joy, pain, and sorrow. Lord, help us to accept the things we cannot change and rely on God's never unfailing strength to see the bright side of this seemingly dark hour. Today is clearly a day of mourning, also a day to celebrate a life lost. We've been brought together once more to mourn the demise of a friend, celebrate the life of a father, an uncle, and a leader in many respects. It is never easy to lose a loved one. That's a special person in our life, a family member, or someone who we work closely with, especially when it happens to our dear departed brother, Neville. Neville loved his family and was respected by all who passed it this way. It's hard to come in turn with his passing. Today, ladies and gentlemen, though our heart ache, I wonder how it will be without our brother, father and a friend, uncle. We take heart because we know that there is someone who cares about us, who is always with us, who will give us hope and strength to go on. Neville served the Jamaica Constable Air Force team as a district constable on the pitch of Rock River Police Station in the Clarina Division for 22 years, 6 months, 21 days, a grand total of 8,216 days up to the time of his passing. He was a victim of hard work, commitment, devotion, and loyalty. As we now traverse the higher cause, we shall thank God for learning the time he shared with us. Today we can say we have a pleasure of knowing a great man, being associated with him, working with him. We count him as a friend and a brother. I am sure the Jamaica Constable Force family, members of the bereaved family, are doing mourning. Thank God for a life well spent. We shall always have no quarrel with death. To everything there's a season, a time and every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up that which was planted. To his family and friend, condolence from the United District Council Association. Psalms 49 verse 15 assures us that God will redeem his soul from the power of the grave, and he shall receive him. Thanks be to God the Creator. He reminded us as we walk through the valley, we do not have to fear evil. He's walking with Neville today. His rod and staff is comforting. I pray that he may find eternal peace. May life perpetually shine in his soul. Peace to all.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
I just have a short scripture to read, and then I'm going to elaborate on my brother's inner life. Reading taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 through to 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will go, bringing with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him, with them, in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. I just want to say, I am really blessed and honored to have a brother like Neville Michael Bernard. He's a fighter. He's a man of true word. Anybody who come across Neville Michael Bernard, he's such an inspiration to everybody. A help, a friend, and a person that you can call on to any time of the day. And I just want to use this word of comfort, knowing that because he's a child of God, we can rest assured, knowing that he's up there, smiling at us up our all. So, you know, friends, families, loved ones, you name it all. The human side is sad, but the spiritual side should be happy, knowing that he is with God. Thank you.
In Baptist Sunday School, please get ready now.
In the storm.
Lost anchor, the storm got you. morning, everyone. On behalf of the Rockefeller Early Childhood Institution, at this time we want to share our sympathy with the Bernards family. I have known Mr. Bernard for many years. He is jovial, loving, trustworthy, reliable persons. These are just some of the attributes that I would use to describe Neville. He was a friend of the staff and students of the Rockefeller Early Childhood Institution. The children loved him. They were always excited when he visited us. You could see him laughing and talking with them, and they were really excited to see him, and he would give them jokes. They also loved his bike. You would see them all over his bike. Neville was such a jovial person that he would not like to see persons in his presence who were sad. He was always saying, "Miss Dyer, you're all right. You sure say you're all right? Your face don't look good, man. What happened to you? You're good?" And I would say, "Yes, we are good." He was that type of a person. Neville was a godly person, always striving to righteousness. He didn't like to see things out of place. Everything should be done in order and in decency. Memories of Mr. Bernard will always be in our hearts. We truly miss him. It was like he was a member of our board, and he was not, but he was that type of a person. And those of us that are alive, that remain, I hope that we will take a page from Mr. Bernard's book. And I'm sure if we do, life will be a better place, a better society. God bless you. May his soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine on his path.
Mr. Allen here. All protocol observed. I bring tribute this morning on behalf of the Bethlehem Baptist Church in memory and celebration of a brother and friend who lived a godly life by deeds done in humanity, humility, and from a heart of wisdom. Deacon Bernard was a beautiful soul, a precious pearl, and a priceless gem that radiated light to all the people who crossed his path. He actively lived out his faith. He served this church as deacon, Sunday school superintendent, and adult Sunday school teacher, faithfully and sacrificially. He also served as a member of the officers' board and various committees for many years. Many valuable lessons were shared, thought, and lived through the gift and talent with which God has blessed him. The Deacon Bernard we know and love as a nurturer. Thank you. Is genuine and well embracing. His compassion and understanding were genuine. He counseled, cared for, and consoled all of us through his ministry. Deacon Bernard was discerning. He knows those who hurt, whose hearts were hurting, and those who were in the midst of worrying situations. Deacon Bernard was an empathic listener. Many of us willingly confided in him, and many bruised spirits were soothed. Deacon Bernard felt and loved people deeply. The Deacon Bernard we know and love was always available. His personal
involvement, outstanding achievements, and accomplishment did not interfere or overshadowed his commitment to the church. Neither did it intrude on how he related to others. Deacon Bernard's voice will be missed at our meetings as he helped to shape the discussions and decisions. He was always alert, frank, and probing, and would persist when an answer was not forthcoming. However, he was always gracious and respectful, never raised his voice or showed signs of impatience. He was punctual, he led by example, and was always in attendance at all church activities. The Deacon Bernard we know and loved was a source of inspiration. He had a natural charm and a deep sense of calm which endeared everyone to him. He loved his love for God and people everywhere and in everyone and was never one to damage or dampen or deflate. Like Barnabas, he was an encourager. And like Lydia, he used his resources to help others. His generosity of spirit enabled others to walk taller, become stronger, and aspire to something more. To many, he was a guiding light. The Deacon Bernard we know and loved was a man of prayer, a peacemaker, and the true servant of God. And so we say farewell to a remarkable brother of the faith. We thank God for loaning him to us. Once again, my brothers and sisters, death forces us to reflect on life and the many lessons that God would have us embrace and reaffirm from the life and death of Deacon Bernard. To the Bernard's family, friends, and especially the wife, Sister Bernard, mother, Mother Sayre, his siblings, his two children, Lurel and Travis. We say to you, do not walk alone. For the eternal God, Deacon Bernard's God, our God, is your refuge, and underneath are his everlasting arms. He will bear you up, he will sustain you as you adjust to life without him. Walk good, my brother. Rest in peace, and life perpetual shines on you. Is my brother Halim here? No. So we are going to change our position at this time. I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing lustily and as you put your hands deeply into your pocket, because if you sit, you might not be able to find one. So I want you to stand up. One of the projects that Deacon Bernard wanted to finish is that we tie this place. We were able to do the rostrum, so we want to move down here. So that next time when you come to a rally, not a funeral, you will be more comfortable. And your hiding shoes won't fall into any cracks. So I'm going to invite you to stand. I'm going to ask the Pastor Rose to pray. Ushers are going to come forward. And in the meantime, you pay for the money and put your offering in the offering plate for the church.
spring. Oh, Father, no God, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks again today for your goodness, for your mercies, for your blessings upon us. We thank you for all the gifts that you have given unto us. And we thank you, Lord God, for the monetary blessing with which you have blessed us. And as we come today, Lord, to give back a portion to a worthy cause, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will accept our offerings. Sanctify them now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we know, dear Lord, that it is to your glory that we give this offering. And may your people experience your blessing as you have said it in your word. That good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into their bosom. Thank you, dear Lord, for the opportunity to give to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
They be seated at the singing of the last stanza of the new stand. Now that you have taken out the money, you can sing. And we are going to sing lustily to the Lord. Listen, the gospel bells are ringing.
The gospel bells are ringing.
Thank you.
Let us hear and make our calling an election sure. Thank you very much. You have been good so far. So we are at the place where we're going to be hearing the remembrance, which will be done by the niece, Mrs. Manraj, that is Miss Manraj, Patrice.
Remembering Neville Michael Bernard. We arrived on the scene of action. We came for a purpose, served that purpose, and then disappeared. During our sojourn, we work, we interact, we serve, we behave, we misbehave, we contribute, or we do not contribute. Whatever our life experiences are, we make an impact on society. This results in the way we are remembered when we depart this life. So, how will we remember Neville Bernard? Let's look at him under three main headings. Neville the family man, Neville the professional, and Neville the community person. As we all know, family life is important, and Neville recognized that. I am sure his dear wife, Kathleen, and his sons, Laurel and Travis, can attest to this fact. He was a very loving and caring husband and father. These roles he played very well as he graciously accepted his responsibility. The support and dedication he showed to his sons as he sought to educate them were admirable. He was firm but gentle. Worthy of note also is the way Neville related to his mother and his eight siblings. Theirs was a very warm and close relationship. He never failed to keep in touch with all of them wherever they were. He had to be reassured that all was well with them. His very close sibling, Angela, fondly remembers one of his favorite utterances, quote, "A soigo, somebody worse than you." This was his response to a stressful situation. It was fun to be around him. The void left by his passing will always be there. As a professional, Neville served his country with distinction. As a member of the security forces, he exemplified dedication and hard work.
Mommy!
All right, let us be calm. Be calm. Take her to the vestry. Take her around to the vestry.
Whether he was doing security work or working as a police officer, he could always be relied on at times. Although his legs were amputated, that never prevented him from doing what he did best, to serve and protect. His colleagues benefited greatly from this hard-working man. Neville Bernard was also a great community person. Whether you were young or old, you were a recipient of his warm smiles and infectious laughter. He was jovial, fun-loving, and easygoing. Even the basic school children were his friends. On his way home from work, he would always greet them as they shouted, "Mr. Bernard!" One was really very comfortable in his presence. To know him was to love him. He was such a genuine soul. But guess what? There comes a time when we all have to approach the departure lounge. Neville Bernard went with his documents in hand, and at the appropriate time, he boarded. We now wish him a safe landing.
Listen to the voice of heaven. Oh, yes. is sounding sweeter all the time. Let us keep heaven on our mind and be rapture ready. Because I left Deacon Bernard here and he was on the outside. He was fine. And I went away for a few weeks and the message I got is that Peter and Bernadette were here together in church. So we have to be rapture ready. So that when he comes, wherever he comes, whenever he comes, we are ready to meet him.
I'm going to be having a selection now from the JCF choir. After which, Mr. Norman Hallin is not here, so we are going to have retired Sergeant Montague to come after that selection. So I'm giving you time, sir, to put your thoughts together. So the selection from the JCF choir is in order.
Thank you. situation. God is in control. Do you believe that?
John saw a city that could not be him. John saw this city.
Oh yes, he did.
John caught a glimpse of the golden throne. Tell me all about it. Come on.
Go right on.
Around the throne he saw clear to see. There's got to be more.
Jerusalem!
stand here this afternoon, I have mixed feelings. But the information I brought is to tell you that I recruited Never. While I was in charge over there, he was one of my recruited the district constable, and we had a very good relationship until I departed there. Now this afternoon I stand here and I was considering, because I was asking my friend right beside me there, should I were to come up here after listening to the choir? But then the moderator said, it's left to me to decide. So what I'm going to do, let me hope you will tolerate me. We have to understand that whatever God does, it is well done. Because
and I started questioning God. And I have I don't think the minister of religion will charge me for that, because my Reverend Paula, who is our first chaplain, told me, you can question God anytime you want to. Yes. And my reason for questioning God is to ask him, why is it that the very, very good people in the society are moving out so fast, and the criminal gunmen who are wrecking havoc. I can't help but asking God, why are these criminals being allowed to continue in their wicked ways? And we are recording crimes from them every day. And even when we lock them up, they continue to get free food and water. Yes. They pay no bills. And they get 3 meals per day. They pay no bills. They get free electricity from the government. And I can't help but question God, forgive me if you think I'm doing something wrong. But they're enjoying life, and our good citizens, like Neville Bernard, move out very, very fast. I just want to encourage you, family members, while I encourage myself and my own staff to be very, very strong. Yes. Eulogy for Constable, District Constable Neville Michael Bernard. Indeed, we are giving thanks for the life of District Constable Neville Bernard, for the sterling service he has delivered as a law enforcement officer. This is a time to remember the fallen and honor their sacrifices. It is a time to remember the families that share in that sacrifice daily. And it is a time to reflect on our own mortality and utter dependence on God. There are countless men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice. We serve, protect this country. Join with me in a reflective mode as this stalwart of the Jamaica Constabulary Force is eulogized. It is indeed quite fitting to juxtapose the life of District Constable Neville Bernard with that of the Psalmist David, as it is symbolic of a shepherd whose main responsibility is to protect his flock in order to ensure that he performed at optimum level. Mr. Bernard believed that the Lord was his shepherd, that he made him to lie down in green pastures. He led him beside the still waters. He believed the Lord always had the capacity to restore his soul, and he was led in the path of righteousness. Neville Michael Bernard, affectionately called Mr. B, Sir B, Brother Nev, Uncle Nev, was born on May 17, 1960 at the Victoria Jubilee Hospital in Kingston to parents George Bernard and Sarah Bernard. His father predeceased him. He began his early education at St. Annie's School, then to the St. Annie's Secondary School. Later, he matriculated to the Parade Gardens Vocational Institute. After leaving school, he was employed to the Alpha Security Company, where he served numerous organizations in the corporate area. During his tenure as a security guard, he went to live with his mother. He was a family man, assisting his mother with his grandmother, who was very sick in the Cool Hills here of Rock River. He fell in love with a beautiful woman named Kathleen, whom he met in this very, very cool district of Rock River. And on September 11, 1993, they became husband and wife. However, his family circumstances changed when his wife announced that they were expecting their first son, Lurel. And on June 6, 1995, he was born. A few years later, he became a proud father of a second son, Travis, born on February 1998. With these words of David as his mantra, District Councilman Neville Bernard was never faced to take on challenges. And so, one of his greatest ambitions was to serve the people of Jamaica. And on May 9, 1994, he was appointed as a member of the Rural Police Force. District Constable Bernard served the Clarendon Division with distinction, and he was stationed at the Rock River Police Station. During his tenure in the Rural Police Force, District Constable Bernard maintained a high level of integrity and professionalism. He is remembered as a good man. Although he was unable to walk due to amputation of both legs in 2014 and 2015 respectively, he was never ever daunted by his challenges. He would be seen driving his scooter to work every morning. On his way to work, he would be greeted by a little boy named Danilo, who always watched out for him and handed him a flower. As a young man growing up, he loved to iron, and so he taught his sons the skills of ironing. Neville would ensure that his wife's clothes were always ready for work, especially her pants. The creases were sharp, that it would peel an orange with it. One of her colleagues at work even commented, "This is Bernard's handwork." And when she saw her in one of the pants, the iron, she was really, really elated. The green pastures and still waters were indicative of a life in which D.C. Bernard was abundantly blessed, and further illustrates the benefits to be derived from a God-led life. Brother Neville was a devoted man of God. He was appointed deacon at Bethlehem Baptist Church, where he served wholeheartedly. He also served as a Sunday school teacher. He would ensure that every Sunday morning, the family had devotion. He loved reading and would be seen reading the newspaper and discussing current affairs with his family. He instilled in his two sons a core value system that defined who he is, both as a father and husband. He was a man who kept promises, honored commitments, and most of all, a man of integrity. On November 26, 2016, District Constable Bernard left for work in a joyful mood. Approximately 12:45 p.m., his son Travis carried his lunch to him. Travis watched him eat his lunch. While he was eating, Travis asked him, "Daddy, are you okay?" His reply was, "I'm fine," he said. "Travis, why did you ask?" But Travis, as well as his brother, Lirel, always liked to observe him when he didn't realize. He either walked through the valley of the shadow of death, he feared no evil, for the Lord was with him, his rod and staff comforted him. About 6 p.m. the same day, District Constable Bernard returned from work. He got off his scooter, got into his wheelchair, wheeled himself to his room, changed his clothes. He returned to his son's room where his wife was resting. They both conversed for a while. When he complained that he was not feeling well, his wife jumped off the bed and embraced him and shouted to her son. He was taken to the Chapelton Hospital, where he died. District Constable Bernard was never daunted when his health began to fail him. He drew on his inner strength with the support of God, who gave him comfort. Although there were days when the mission statement of the Jamaica Constabulary Force became a figment of his imagination, District Constable Bernard still held fast, steadfast to his faith. It was always his conviction to God that had him prepared a table before him in the presence of his enemies, and that he anointed his head with oil, and his cup was overflowing. Surely goodness and mercy followed him all the days of his life. District Councilman Bernard clearly promised of blessings and protection, even in the face of illness and adversities. Like David, like Solomon, Neville Bernard is a shepherd to his flock. He is the epitome of the old adage, do good and good will follow you. He lived an exemplary life. As given unwavering support, he fought a good fight, and he has finished his course. Neville Michael Bernard lives to celebrate his life. His mother, Sarah, wife of 23 years, Kathleen, sons, Laurel and Travis, brothers, Danny, Andrew, Richie, Tito, sisters, Joan, Fair, and Pat, sister-in-law, brother-in-law, nieces, nephews, also relatives, co-workers, and friends. He served the Rural Police Force in the office of District Constable from May 9, 1994 until his passing on November 26, 2016. We extend gratitude to his family and for sharing their never with us, with the Jamaica Constabulary Force and the Rural Police Force. May his soul rest in peace and life perpetual. Shine on him. I must encourage you to try your very, very best to be strong and to accept the things that we cannot change. And we all must move on. Thank you very much.
I want to thank SP Cameron Powell for eulogizing our brother and friend so ably. And I took keen note of how attentive you were. You listened carefully to the life of our brother. There's going to be a man coming shortly, our pastor, Michael Barnett, who will be coming with the word. And I want you to give him your undivided attention. So make sure you take your seats, no moving up and down, because when the sermon is being preached, some people tend to take time, walk out, and go down the road to take a drink. Because I've gone to many funerals, and that's what I see. When the eulogy is being read, we sit and we listen. And we want to hear how the dead person used to live. And how much nickname have and how much girlfriend they keep. And when the sermon is being preached, the church empty. But I'm really happy that you are being cooperative and you are listening. Reverend Barnett is the pastor of this church. He pastors 5 churches in the circuit. Hard-working minister, Mitchell's Hill, Mount Zion, Bethlehem, Pindus Valley, and Moores. He will bring the word of comfort to the family and to all of us who need the word. So I invite you to sit back and give your undivided attention as he brings the message. But before he does that, the choir will minister to us in song.
Sometimes alone, on the Lord, I go. It's me. It is with the utmost sincerity that I want to offer on behalf of my family, my church family, the circuit, our sincere condolences, our prayers for the family, wife, children, relatives, friends, well-wishers. Sincerest condolences. And it is our prayer that as a church body, that the Lord's presence will be felt during this time. We also offer ourselves to you to aid you in any way that we can. We offer ourselves to you, and we pray that God's peace will be with you. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts find acceptance in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. When someone as well loved as Deacon Bernard passes away, we feel sorrow. We feel anxiety, worry, and fear compass us about. And it is in times of uncertainty like this that the text brings comfort. The text that we shall read brings comfort to us. So I want to draw our attention to Psalm 116 and the verses 12 through to 15. What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows unto the Lord, now in the presence of all his people. Precious, precious, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Today we are gathered here to honor the life of Deacon Neville Bernard. We are here today to offer also comfort to his family, relatives, and friends by our words and by our presence. And finally, we are here, present, to hear what Almighty God will say to us through his word about the realities that we experience in life, in death, and of life eternal made possible through his Son, Jesus Christ. In Psalms 116 and verse 15, we are reminded, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. To us, dear friends, death never seems under any condition to be a precious thing. We think of death as an enemy. We think of death in terms of a loss. But the Apostle Paul says that death is gain. Why do we think of death as a loss? Well, today we have lost a father,
uncle, a brother, a friend, someone that we love. So we think of death in terms of loss. But because Deacon Neville Bernard had a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, established by an abiding faith in him, his death was called precious. And I can hear someone say, how can God say that death is precious? We heard that echo in the sentiments of Sister Powell. But first, we must attempt, in order to see things as precious in God's sight, we have to see from the way that God sees it. For as we look at things in the natural, we cannot agree with that statement. But God sees everything as it stands in terms of his eternal order and purpose. So today, let us consider some ways in which death, the death of a Christian, is precious. Firstly, the death of a Christian is precious because it frees us from suffering and pain.
Amen.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
There is much, you would agree with me, in this life that we can say spoils our happiness. And for Deacon Bernard, perhaps it was a battle with some illness. Perhaps it was the fact that he lost his mobility in losing his legs. So Deacon Bernard faced every day with courage. And I believe that courage was given to him by Almighty God. And he could attest to the truth found in Revelation 21 and verse 4. That God himself will wipe away every tear from our eyes. We are promised there that there shall be no more death, no more sorrow, no more crying, no more pain. For the former things pass away. Someone has said, do not be afraid of tomorrow. For God is already there in your tomorrow. Deacon Bernard moved out of his body and moved into a new residence, a new home in heaven, prepared for him. God has been with him every step of the way. So the death of a Christian is guided by Almighty God. It frees us from suffering and pain. But not only from suffering and pain. Secondly, the death of a Christian is precious because it provides us with an entrance into heaven.
Amen.
For the person, for the man, the woman, the boy or girl who has surrendered their life to Jesus Christ, it is but a changeover from earth to glory. Paul put it this way when he said, so we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. We are confident, yes, well pleased rather, to be absent from the body, and to be present with the Lord. And you find that in 2 Corinthians 5, verse 6 and 8. So then, my friends, for the believer in the Lord, death is merely a change of place, a change of state, a transfer from one realm to another. So death for the Christian is not to be feared, for Christ himself has conquered death for us, and for all those who trust in him. Deacon Bernard knew the truth of this scripture, so he could depart this life with confidence and be present with his Lord and Savior. Do you have that confidence? Do you have that assurance of eternal life beyond this place that we are so familiar with? The truth is, today we all must face this fact that we will all die unless we hear before that the trumpet sound and Christ himself part the clouds and come down to receive his own. All of us will spend eternity somewhere. This life is the only time that we have to prepare for eternity. This is the only time and place we have to make the right choice. Either an eternity with God in the splendor of heaven, or an eternity separated from God, spent in hell. My friends, I make no apologies of telling you that there is a place called heaven, and there is a place called hell. All of us must go to one of those places. Hebrews 9 and 27 reminds us that it is appointed for men once to die, but after this, the judgment. So in light of this, we all should take heed and take care as to the kind of life that we live, so that when our time comes to die, we will be ready to face God. I believe that Deacon Neville Bernard was ready. The question is, are you and I ready? When our final hour on earth comes, where will we spend eternity? Scripture warns us to be ready. And readiness does not consist of any amount of good works that we have done. No amount of membership that you may have in the church. No rank or position that you occupy in the church. Not baptism. Not any other ritual that you can name. Readiness is established by accepting the free gift of salvation that Jesus Christ offers to us all. It's simply a matter of turning your life over to God through Jesus Christ. The promise of Jesus to us all is that he has gone to prepare a place for us. And in John 14 verse 2, Jesus declares, "In my Father's house are many mansions." Hallelujah. "If it were not so, I would have told you." Jesus is not no scammer. He is not no deceiver. He is not no liar. He said, "If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you." Hallelujah. The Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 1, "For we know that if our earthly house, this tent, is destroyed, we have a building from God." Friends, what a joy. What a joy to know that the Apostle Paul can remind us that this fleshly body is just a tent, a temporary dwelling place. When this tent is worn out, God has prepared a place for us. Someone said, "Heaven
is a prepared place for prepared people. I pray that all of us here today are prepared people. Oh, praise the name of God. I pray that Deacon Neville Bernard's example will be an example that you will follow.
Yes.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And we go or several places of abode, we forget. So even as I pray, whisper a prayer in your heart. And even as I pray, if it is that you heard the voice of God, and it is your desire to prepare your heart to meet God, right where you are, whisper a prayer to God and say to us, that God still hears and still answers prayer. If you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth, you can be saved. Holy Spirit of God, continue to move in this place, challenging hearts, drawing men and women unto yourself. As we reflect on the life of Neville, may we pause to reflect on our own mortality. Be reminded that like Neville's day came, our day will come.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah.
And if we are not ready,
Jesus,
where will we spend our may persons, O God, come to realize that your arms are outstretched, bidding them to come home, for it is supper time. In his lifetime, he challenged many. I pray, God, that even at his funeral service, that he will continue to challenge persons. Persons will see the need to make that all-important decision. We thank you, God, for his service, for his strength. We thank you for his unwavering faith and his courage. Many, O God, who are able-bodied, many who have all their limbs intact and so many good things happening for them, sit and complain about what is not happening. But, O God, this man has been through much. But even as he goes through what he has been through, his faith in you was risen. We thank you, God. Today, while we grieve and mourn his loss, we are comforted by the fact that precious in your sight is the debt of the same. For, O God, debt gives liberation. Debt brings hope. But Lord, we know that while we say that and while we believe that, when our back is against the wall, when we have to face the reality of losing a loved one. But we know it is true that precious in your sight is the debt of the same. We mourn. We question why. God, we believe this afternoon his mother, his wife, his sons, his siblings, his nieces and nephews, his colleagues are asking questions. God, you are a comforting God. I pray that at this moment you will come alongside them, that you will put your arms around them, and that you will remind them that you are there for them, you are there with them, and that you will not leave them nor forsake them. Though they go through the valley of the shadow of death, you are there with them. And Lord, I pray that you will whisper your sweet peace in their ear. Let them know, O God, that it can be well, that it is well, for you are God. Let them know, O God, that in spite of and regardless of what they're going through, that you are there for them, for you are their Jehovah Jireh. You are the God who lingers with them when everybody else are gone. In the wee hours of the morning, when the memories flood their heart, when the tears flow, and God, when persons who say they will be there are not there, you are there. We thank you, God, for the songwriter declares that you walk with us, you talk with us, and you tell us we are yours in those moments, God, where the tears are flowing, when the questions flood their mind, remind them, oh God, that you're there with them. Lord, I present family members to you, every single one of them. I pray, God, that you will cover them. I pray, God, that you, your peace will be with them. Lord, I present this colleague to you. Lord, as they continue to fight this monster of crime and violence, I pray, oh God, that you will cover them. Cover them, God. God, when their situation seems hopeless, when it appears as if crime and violence is having its upper hand, remind them, oh God, that you're a God of justice, and that good will conquer evil, and that evil will not prevail forever. So God, may they take a grip, another grip, and hold fast, yes, and not to let go. May they be resolute in the carrying out of their duties. Bless them, we pray. Bless the family members, we pray. Bless the church family, we pray. Bless every person who is associated with this brother, who his mourning is lost at this time. Come by them right now and whisper your sweet peace in their ears. In Jesus' name.
He's like a river attendant my way, and sorrow I see heal us from. My Lord, thou art taught me to say,
it is well, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well.
Whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord, both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. A symbol of his life to make a land he loved. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will give new life to a mortal body. Our heart therefore is glad, and our spirit rejoices. Our body shall rest in hope. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. And at the last, let us not fall away from you. Ensure and certain hope. hope of resurrection and to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. We commend to Almighty God our brother Bernard, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ash to ash, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness and grace to give us your grace to live and die in your favor, so that when your well-beloved Son Jesus Christ shall come again, both this, our brother Bernard, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. From the rising of the sun to the setting thereof, we will remember them, we will remember them. Give it and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. As soon as the sun, then the brother and relatives.
Brother.
And as we continue with the service, we have the hymn, Sing the Wondrous Love of Jesus. Sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, while the workmen continue with the closure of the vault. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus in His mercy. In the mansion, when we all
get together, what a day!
Father.
Let us then be true and faithful.
Let us then be true and faithful.
Trust Him, serve Him.
Trust Him, serve Him every day.
Just one glimpse.
Just one glimpse of Him in glory.
Will the toils of life.
When we all. When we all.
Get to heaven.
Get to heaven.
What a day.
What a day.
When we all see Jesus,
when we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
By and by, when the morning comes, when all the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we overcome. We will understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, when all the saints of God are gathered round, we will tell the story how we overcome. We will understand it better by and by.
Some sweet day, I'm going away. I'm gonna leave this world, no more to roam.
Some sweet day, when life is over. Some sweet day, I'm going away. Some sweet day.
Glory, I'm
gonna sing redemption story. I'm gonna walk the streets of glory by and by.
Yes,
I'm gonna walk the streets of glory by and by. Walk those streets of
Mata,
glory,
sing and shout.
I'm gonna walk those streets of glory. I'm gonna sing redemption story. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory by and by.
When I get there,
when I get there, I will sing and shout.
Someday I'll go where Jesus is. I'll be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him in heaven. I'll be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness,
going on the morning. What are we?
Listen, what are we says?
Children. Oh, our Heavenly Father. Now sing the next quote. I have a seat. Why are you looking at? Believe that we are going home on the morning train. Up in heaven,
give me spin.
We'll have a no spin. In heaven, what a grand time! Sing glory, hallelujah! We'll have a grand time up in heaven. What we still the perfect planet. We'll have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. What a grand time. sing it.
Walking in the angel, singing hallelujah. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time.
All right.
Oh, we shall have a grand time up in heaven.
We have to be upon her.
We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time. Hey. Walking in the angel, sing glory, hallelujah.
We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time.
No grave,
no grave, and hold my body down.
No grave, don't worry.
No grave, and hold my body down. No grave, and hold my body down. But when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave.
Lord, as we stand
in this cemetery, we are cognizant of the fact that one day we may find ourselves in such a position as our dear brother. We pray, O Lord, that you would grant unto us your grace and your mercy, that we will make available ourselves to receive the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. The gospel is preached for our benefit. Salvation is offered to all humankind. And one day we must tell you what we have done with your gift. So, Lord, prepare all of us for that day when we too will find ourselves in your presence, as our dear brother is now. Grant peace to us all. Take home safely those who have traveled from far, and cause that your blessing, mercy, and peace from Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. Rest eternal. Grant to him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Our Lord is risen. Our Lord is risen indeed. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Sleep on me, love, and sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon your Savior's breast. We love you well, but Jesus loves you best. Good night.
Protect you, trouble neglect you, and heaven accept you. When it's time to go home, may you always have plenty, your glass never empty, and know in your belly you're never alone. May your tears come from laughing, you find friends worth having. With every year passing, they mean more than gold. May you win, but stay humble, smile more than grumble, and know when you stumble, you're never alone.